Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the Rational Investors Bitcoin summary video here for what's today? Today is Wednesday, July 16th, 2014. It's about 9 o'clock here in the morning, Pacific time, so I do understand it's a little later today on the video. But one of the charting sites that I like to use is having lots of problems this morning, so I had to wait for them to get their act together. We have class starting here in about 2 hours, so I'm gonna try and make this daily summary as brief as possible. Keep in mind, everyone, these free videos are actually going to be down sized to like 5 to 10 minutes. That was supposed to be the original goal. And as I sort of work my way through getting this site and service up and running, what I'll probably transition to is these longer videos are going to be posted for them in the members page. And just a quick 5-10 minute summary for all you freebies on YouTube. So let's get to the analysis nice and quick. As we always start off, here's our daily chart of the BTCE. We all know why I'm using BTCE. We can see big run up, correction back into the optimal trade entry long zone. Not a big surprise. Every time it got down here, it was rejected. And off of this sell-off through the winter and spring, here is the OTE short zone up here. So if we were going to continue the rally, that's kind of the neighborhood I'm looking for. Having said that, here in the short term, we're at a real battle point here. You can see this uptrend line off of the lows through the winter and spring, and we're just sitting right on the trend line right now. If I look at some of the internal indicators, momentum has been in bear divergence for a while, so we have to be a bit concerned about that. Willie, while not stupid at the present, I would say basically just consolidating. Got a little bit of a sell flash here a few hours ago. So kind of like with the raw momentum reading, certainly nothing to write home about right at the moment. And then if we look at money flow, we can see that the volume OBV is broken down here. It's negative at the moment, and we're threatening to break to new lows. If we go through this level here, then that'll be lower high and lower low. And as I've been talking about, we're basically into the summer doldrums here, so volume levels themselves are just dried up. So I don't really foresee a major calamity here. As I've been saying recently, I think the market's basically range bound between this 668 high and these lows. What was this low here? 555, and this low is 554. So long and short of it is it's about $100 trading range. If we zoom in on the 4 hour, you'll remember last class, I guess not last class, but last video, I had suggested that I would feel a lot better if Willie could get nice and stupid here, so we can see that that's working its way out. We do actually have a potential bullish momentum divergence building here, so we'll see how that plays out, but certainly no signals just yet. And OBV, you can see we've put in a double top. We're rolling over. We're getting some chunky red bars here. And I had suggested to you guys yesterday that we had this move here off of this bat target high. Then we had dead cat bounce, which was 50% of this level. Put in a triple top. So I said if I was a betting man and I was asked to conjecture as to where price wanted to go here in the short term, I still think we really have a high probability of going down into this 580, 590 area. And that's where my circle is here, and you can see the bear A, B, C, D. I suppose one could argue we might have a bearish bot forming here on the intradays, the 4 hours here. We had a potential bullish bot forming here, but basically that fizzled out with the failure of this level. And again, here's that $100 trading range, these two major trend lines. That's basically what I think the market is trapped within. So if we do come down to this bear ABCD target, that'll be right into this optimal trade entry zone that you can see on the chart here, and it would be right up against this major trend line. So let's zoom in on the 1 hour and see what's going on there. So long and short of all this is just off of the 1 hours. Coming out of the weekend, you know, here's that 38.2. Here's the OTE sweet spot here, tag. So nice double bottom we came out of. Here was the risk reward on that double bottom. Wasn't 2-1, so I wasn't really overexcited about taking it, but indeed it worked. There's the 50% level, and here's that major trend line. So not a big surprise. We stalled up in this area. We consolidated for quite a while, and I thought I had a bullish bot. Here was the A, B, and C, D would have taken us up here into this OTE short zone. And as you can see by the setup boxes, that basically that consolidation failed and it broke through the bottom. So as a result, we just hopped off on the sidelines. And I've just been sort of cautioning that I'm more reluctant to get involved on the long side just yet. We are starting to see some constructive action here. The Humphrey Hawkins testimony is winding up fairly shortly. So as a result, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we just drifted here while Janet Yellen was talking. And if we can put in a good-looking bottom here on momentum and volume, we are right at the OTE sweet spot for the 1 hour. So we'll see how this goes. But as I said, off of the higher time frames, I'm concerned that we really do need to come down in here into this maybe even tag 600 kind of idea. You can see 61.8 here is 587. You know, that to me seems like a perfectly realistic target here in the short term. And until we start getting higher lows and higher highs, I'm going to have to just sort of curtail my bullish enthusiasm. So as you can see, this low here was, where are we here, 611 on the nose, and the lows we made this morning here, what a coincidence, that was right into the London or the New York kill zone. That low 609.80. So still big hurry up and do nothing for me for long considerations. And I was thinking about it last night. The interesting thing here is we did have the short setup here off of this 640 level. And I suppose one could argue that, you know, that short is still working. You know, if you had not taken profits on these 38.2 tags or the OTE sweet spot tags, at the very least, I would hope that you have sold half and your stop is just sitting up here at 629 on the remaining position. So that's basically your summary for today. You know, until Humphrey Hawkins gets out of the way in earnest, it's kind of a hurry up and do nothing for me. I do like the price action in here, so let's see how this hourly OTE plays itself out. If we get a nice good-looking consolidation and a double bottom, I might just start getting enthusiastic again about the bulls at camp. But anyway, so that's your summary for today. Have yourself a great day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye for now.